8-bit instrumentation.
Produced by Soundman and NVX Audio. Premium iPad dash kits and custom dash mods at soundman.co. High quality car stereo, amp, speakers, and vehicle specific bass packages.
Bass!
NVX.com. We are also sponsored by US Alternators and downforsoundshop.com.
Oh, take a look at what we have here.
Today I'm going to build a complete subwoofer box, start to finish, for a 1969 Chevy Nova from my friends at Outlaw Garage, and I'm talking about the status of the bass war and how I really screwed myself.
We have a couple of J Smell Audio 8s.
First, I'll design my box.
Now we're going 2 J Smell 8s. We have a maximum height of 10 inches, a width of 26, and a depth of 13. We need the port on the left and the woofers up. So if I do some quick calculations, we got 10 by 26 by 13 equals divided by 1728. So I'm gonna draw my desired box and then this is gonna fire up. Look at that, we're gonna go 20 wide. They're putting a battery next to this in this region. You know, some sort of little battery here. So we'll give them plenty of room. We'll keep it 8 inches high and then we'll do a 12 depth. We're gonna have 0.73 cubic feet. Look at that. So let's design our cut sheet. So the top and bottom will be 18.5 by 12. I want the woofer baffle to sit on top of the sides for structural integrity. And that's it, baby, look at that. So I'll move the Chevy out real quick to not get sawdust on my paint. Then we'll cut these. And then before we assemble it, we'll cut the woofer holes and the port hole.
We have 2 new entries into the bass war. Bass Cop called me out. And a guy named Adam Francis. Who the hell is Adam Francis? Both of these competitors are ahead of Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd, who has been putting out sellout headphone videos and Crutchfield videos. His boxes don't even bump. Only rich people buy from Crutchfield. Price is so high they have enough leftover money to pay Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd, to make ads that don't work. Who the hell buys from
Crutchfield? I'm officially announcing that I'm entering the Bass Wars. You got problems now, Doug. No more picking on the little man, EXO!
Goddamn UPS truck's pulling in my way.
Next, I'm going to cut all my pieces.
Raise this blade up about 9 inches. Slap this on over to 18.5. Easy money, baby. This is the only dust mask I have available. This is a penis flavored COVID mask. One of you sent this to me. Thank you for my penis mask. I'm not gonna get wood in my mouth, but I have wood on my mouth. Can I help you? Okay, so I can rip it once this way, and then give it a... Oh, baby! This is our top and our front and back. It's gonna be something like this. That's gonna be a small little baby. Look at that little sucker. Now I need 2 8x12s. I could probably cut that with a scrap. Look at this baby. Set this here to 12. So one of these sides will get a port, and since it's gonna be assembled, these will be put on like an end cap type of situation. And it's 12 deep, so we'll put the port. I have a 4-inch port template I made. Okay, well then we're gonna hit it down just about right here. We're gonna line up the bearing to the right there. That, but we're 10 minutes in. Then this will go together like this. Will it fit? This is too small. What happened here? I did some math wrong. How is that possible? Hang on a second. Oh, the sides are too big. These are supposed to be 6.5. So I fucked up. Wouldn't you know it? Okay, so this will be something like this. Look at that construction, baby. I already have some recessed 8-inch woofer holes programmed. So I'll just slap this on the CNC, cut the woofer holes, and we'll glue it together. Baby. Oh, baby. Give it one of these. Right about there should be swell.
A reverse shell two-stage exploit. The ideal package. Load the malware into a femtocell delivery system.
I don't want the woofer magnets to hit the port.
Doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
And here's where I really screwed up with the bass fan and got a pickle stuck inside myself. The rule is to never work on two project cars at the same time. I thought I could be the one to do it. I planned on working on the bass fan and putting the mule back together. Working on two project cars at the same time is like having two wives at the same time. You could barely handle one. And neither one of them's getting done. Now, as a veteran YouTube celebrity, I realize I should work on one car, finish it to completion, sell it for an astronomical fee, and then move on to my next masterpiece. My next huge mistake was deciding to take on customer Dashmod projects in order to generate money to sink into the bass fan project. Now I'm so overloaded with customer Dashmod projects, I don't have time to work on the stupid cocksucking bass fan. Cockford Ballsgate!
You got problems now, Doug.
Now I'm going to assemble my pieces.
Assembling unit. Ooh, yeah. Look at that, huh? Oh, right into my thumb.
then I decided to buy another car. Why? I got a great deal on a 57 Chevy Bel Air. Now I'm so overwhelmed with turds, I don't know which turd to blow first. Fucking turd blower, idiot. I honestly feel like selling everything and starting over. Mark Zuckerberg, the car audio nerd, doesn't have these problems. You know why? Because he buys Jeep products. Which means he's probably more interested in dudes than cool cars. He's not even a car guy. A goddamn poser. If there was a way to mall grab a Jeep, that would be him. Before I upholster this, I'm gonna pop in some hardware. Next, I'm going to install T-nuts in the box and make a terminal. Pause if you would like to retain this information. This is my box hardware bin. See, what we do is we use 8x32x1-inch screws and T-nuts for the facial unit. And then I like to make a little T-nut and wing nut terminal out of some number 10x24x1¼. And I have my appropriate drill bits in here. So this is all ready to go. This little box hardware box is ready. I've got some masking tape on my screw so I don't mar the face of the woofer. Smash these into place. I like to smash my nuts into the face with my Nipex pliers wrench. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, baby. This one up here will need an insert nut. So I'll have to insert my nut into the face on that one. This Nipex pliers wrench has uniform clamping pressure. So it gives it a nice squeeze. Adding glue. Oh yeah, that's a good amount of glue there. Look at that, huh? Would you look at it? Just look at it. Perfection, baby. Put the terminal right here. I'm gonna put them right here for optimal easeability. Ream it like so. I like to make a terminal by putting the T-nut on the outside and stick a bolt in from the inside with the wires on it. I'll show you in a minute, okay? Let's carpet the fucking thing first. Don't get ahead of myself. Now that I'm 44, I recently quit smoking weed. And now I'm left to deal with all of my high decisions. I got so damn high I bought a Subaru for shit's sake. I just want one good project car and a cheap daily driver. I'll take a Toyota Gayrola.
I don't even give a shit.
I think the Subaru's turning me gay. I could really go for a nice fat cock to suck right about now. Should I slam the Subaru on air ride or nah?
Doug. We'll start the seam towards the middle of the box here, like this. I'm gonna rotate it up like this. And then I'll rotate it like this again here.
Now I'm going to upholster this turd so I can get paid.
Stick this under here like this. Oh, a little bit of a, give us a little bit of maskability. I think I'm gonna use my 3M gun because I have some 1.8 tips. This has a disposable cup and a disposable tip situation. Here, see?
Oh, it's got a 1.8 right on her. How much shall we use? Then we're gonna put this on like this. Oh yeah, baby. Get on there, bitch. Get the fuck on there. Now we're gonna lock the cup onto the gun. Locking unit. Oh yeah. Okay, look at that system. That's looking horny to me. High output alternators and power control modules. Upgrade your charging system at usalternators.com. Fastest shipping, best prices on the biggest brands from an authorized dealer. Go to downforsoundshop.com. Look at the accuracy. Oh, that's got a horny spray to it, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, baby, look at the landing. Flipping unit. Gonna give this a nice straight slice. Oh, baby. Look at that magic. Look at this butt seam. I'm gonna seam this butt. Perfect little butt crack. Look at that. Ooh. Cut up from the corners. Oh yeah, but be careful not to slice into my femur artery.
Grew up in a place where they told you what to chase, told you how to run the race. Every move was on the page, but I didn't like their way. Had to fight and misbehave.
Oh yeah,
had to
baby.
Find a way to change. Had to leave to find my way. Caught up in a daydream. I beat my mind up there almost daily. It's how I pass time, no opinions safely. It's how I understand what I want in this place. See, cause everybody wanna tell you bad things. What could go wrong? What fame brings, but success is a finicky thing. And if you ain't sure, no, it'll never be.
Ooh yeah.
I don't wanna let myself down.
Check out this custom terminal method. I'm gonna strip this wire like this. Oh, we got some nice thick red and black. Yeah, baby. Oh yeah.
We're gonna give this a twist-a-roni. These are 4-ohm woofers, so we're gonna run them in parallel. Oh, give it a crimp. We're gonna grab 2 of these 10 24s. And then we're gonna get a couple of these like that. And then we're gonna go like this. Ooh, ooh, yeah. Then we're gonna pop this through the hole. Then I'm gonna give them a start thread. Then I'm gonna smack my nuts, then thread them on through. Thread them through your anus. Oh yeah, nice and tight. Oh yeah, oh, oh, ooh, 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 ooh. May as well throw a couple more stainless washers on there in case he wants to use a fork terminal. I like to mark these like this. This one's positive. This is negative. Like that, look at that. Boom, baby. Check out this double strip job we're about to pull here. Oh. Oh, baby. Shit, howdy, brother. We've got probably about a 7.2 internal volume. What if we did like a 15-incher, 4x15? I really need your advice. What would you do if you're in my position? So far, I sold the T-Bird, which is the only car I ever finished, and I have an unfinished Astro van and an unfinished Volkswagen, and a 57 Bel Air that breaks every time I look at it, and a Subaru probably gonna blow my ring lands soon.
You got problems now, Doug.
Should I sell them all and buy 2 Jeeps? Now I'm going to use WinISD Pro to simulate my output and calculate my port length.
So we're at 7.2 internally, and we did a 4x16 incher. We'd be tuned at 49 hertz.
Everything was revealed. The secret of the perfect hack, make it infallible.
I'm gonna leave this kind of tuned a little bit high so this old guy listens to that doo-wop. This guy's listening to the Beach Boys, so we don't need it to drop crazy low. Next time I might want to do a 3-inch port though. A 3-inch port, I can get a little bit lower of a tune with a shorter port. We're gonna have a 4-inch diameter port, we'll go with 16 inches long. I could have tuned it lower with a 3-inch port. For this particular customer, a higher tune will be fine. But if it was me, I would want to tune it a bit lower with, I'd want a little bit more hump to it.
Leave a comment. I'll see you guys next time.